Rise and shine, Pickles, my love.
You a cop?
No.
Am I in detox?
No.
And then it's all gravy.
God, she's cute. Everyone, I have an important family matter to discuss.
Aw, crap. Is this another intervention?
Mom, I have a problem. I think I'm in love.
Oh, sweetie, your first love. Oh, my little boy's growing up.
Mom, you smell like beer nuts.
I know.
The problem is the girl I love is from the hills.
Oh, boy. Well, my advice is to follow your heart. When I was young, you know, I lived in the hills. But then I met your father, and we fell in love and moved down here to the valley. And you know what? All my hair fell out, and I started drinking.
Please tell me there's more.
Of course, silly. Now, I found a great bar right next to a wig store, and I get to wake up every morning next to the sweetest man in the world.
Hello, Christine.
Pickles! Fabulous to see you. Love your hair. Where'd you buy it?
Off some whore. I think it was your mother.
Well, gotta run. I don't want my daughter and her friends exposed to a drunken hose bag. Oh my gosh, did I say that out loud?
Good. Look, a novelty license plate that says Debbie.
It's showtime.
You got pretty hair.
Enjoy.
And so, the sexual odyssey of these two strangers breaks every taboo, leading to an unforgettable 9.5 weeks.
Read me another video box, Mommy.
No, honey, it's time to board the sleepy train to Slumberland, where fairies make all your sweet dreams come true. Lockdown!
My tie pop?
What's the occasion?
Milo got suspended from school for doing something unspeakable with a fish stick.
And this is his punishment?
Well, I started to spank him, and somehow it turned out like this.
Well, the best laid plans. Anywho, I've got something here that just might help.
Oh, Bob, I don't want him smoking that stuff.
Foxy and I will be best friends forever.
Remember, hon, nothing lives forever. But when he croaks, I can use him as an ashtray.
My little Martha Stewart. Milo, bedtime!
Remember, if he goes for the window, get him with the net. I'll be right behind you with the stun darts. And Bob, if I don't make it, I want you to be buried alive with me.
Yes, dear.
When something you love depends on you, you just want to take care of it and make sure it's safe. Know what I mean?
Not really, no.
Where's Scotty? What are you doing?
Burying beer. Oh, crud. That means I drank gopher poison.
Milo seems nervous.
And no appetite.
He's like this burnout at school, crackhead Lenny. Yeah, what a total wasteoid. He steals tools from shop, never eats. He's all sweaty and jittery. Can he sleep over this weekend?
Sure, he sounds nice.
Could it get any worse?
Get it off! Get it off! Get it off! Get it off!
Well, Biff has a lot of potential, but no initiative. And Chip has a lot of initiative, but no potential.
Well, either way, they're ahead of the game. The doctors were sure one of them would shrivel up and fall off. Ugh. Either I am really smashed, or you and your friends look exactly alike.
We want ham buckets.
Who the hell are you, and what in God's name is a ham bucket? $50.
50 bones? I ain't got that kind of scratch. I work for a living, lady.
For Milo's little friends, they're on the house.
But they'll cheapen the coolness factor.
Do you want another spanking like last night?
Mom, that wasn't me. That was Dad.
That's none of your business. Enjoy.
Thank you, Mrs. Oblong. May the road always rise up to meet you. May...
You go play now.
Man, I wish we could eat decent food like this every day.
I wish you could, too, but that would involve me in the kitchen, and I'm just not seeing. Milo, you wouldn't be cool if it weren't for my designs.
Mamacita. I think you've got it backwards. Your designs wouldn't be cool if I hadn't worn them.
You're just like Tommy Vinegar. I made him cool, too, and then it went to his head. Uppity bitch boy.
Oh, that is an eye-watering stink.
I don't give a rat's heinie what you think. I like it.
Your blasé attitude suggests you know something I don't. Therefore, I shall buy your product outright and market it as my own. I'll just carry these vats out to my Chevrolet minivan.
Hey, there's enough here to buy the school a stove! With just enough left over to get me bombed.
Now I see what you mean about attitude, Mom. But how do you not care about what people think?
Well, I am married to a great guy, and I have great kids, and you all think I'm cool, so I must be.
So you're saying I should marry Dad?
You just ruined what could have been a very poignant family moment.
Should we hug anyway?
I don't care.
Attaboy! Okay, I've got to be smoking constantly. I'm going to win that shopping spree, even if I have to inhale through a hole in my neck.
That's my girl.
Couldn't you just open the packs and look for the winner?
No, you have to smoke them down to the filter to see if you've won. They want to make sure you actually suck the stuff into your lung.
Clever rascals.
Crap. Taking a smoke break.
Someone's up early. And arranging daffodils. Your cigarette withdrawal seems to be going swimmingly. Oh!
Oh, God, I'm sorry.
No, no, I understand. It's only expected that you have irrationally violent moments like that.
Oh! I'm sorry, but you were asking for it that time. You don't know how hard this is. I've lost my best friend.
Pickles, I thought I was your best friend.
Yeah, that's sweet. And what the hell am I supposed to do with my smoking hand?
Please, just don't hit me with it. Pickles, what are you doing?
Suddenly all my senses are back. I just discovered that everything has a smell, and I don't like it. Did you know vomit tastes bad?
Yes, I've heard rumors to that effect.
Oh, God, I smell feet, and lots of them.
You're breaking free of the chains of addiction, casting off the... Pickles, you're lighting your finger on fire.
Oh, for crying out loud. Look at that. That was a perfectly good finger. All right, I gotta quit the booze, too.
No! I mean, why?
Smoking and drinking go together, like porn and nachos. Now I'm gonna open the floor to a little Q&A.
This is a public school. They don't understand letters.
Mrs. Oblong, I wanna thump some ass, too. But will that make me any less of a woman?
No, but scratching your butt with a salad fork will. I learned that the hard way.
What happened to those meaty, meaty sausages?
Sorry, evidence.
All right. Got any spare change?
Get a job.
I guess I win.
Pickles, thank you for agreeing to meet me in the backyard. What I have to say is not front yard talk. The fact is, you've replaced your previous addictions with thrill-seeking.
Oh, Bob, it's not an addiction. It's just an overwhelming need that controls my life.
That's a rattlesnake!
Yeah, I've timed this so I only have 15 minutes to get to the pharmacy for the anti-venom.
Son of a...
Would you be a love and help me to the car? I seem to be paralyzed.
Oh, Lordy! Kids, start the car!
Hey, Mom, want to play some Russian roulette?
How many bullets?
One in every chamber.
I'm in! Huh?
I'm sorry for the deception, but dang it, this is an intervention!
Milo, be a deer and shoot Mommy in the head.
Dad'll get mad. Everyone loves Manic. I even sold a bottle to Mrs. Conway, the diabetic, and a six-pack to the paramedics who rushed her to the hospital.
I'm so proud of my little capitalist.
Today in school, I made a macaroni pencil holder.
Maybe tomorrow you can make your daddy a macaroni shattered dreams holder. Better yet, hollow out one of these peas, so I'll have some place to keep my dignity.
So how was work today, sweetie?
I can't take it anymore, Pickles. The truth must be told.
All right. I'm the one who farted and ruined Christmas. Poor Helga. How can they leave that fat little girl down there?
Don't worry, sweetie. Have a little faith in the system.
Bob, the hill people are the system. If we don't take care of our own, no one will.
Let me tell you something, Missy. Without the system, we'd be no better than dirty apes, eating bananas, peels and all. Ooga booga! Ooga booga! Is that what you want?
God, it makes me hot when you're forceful and stupid.
What was that?
It's the toilet, stupid. I mean, Dad, Mom said it.
Don't worry, Helga. Now that the water is off in the whole city, you can bet the hill people will do something. Here, this'll keep you warm, honey. And beautiful.
My bottom is moist.
There's a shocker.
No, he's right. The water level seems to have risen a little.
Oh, well. It's not like it's an ominous sign or anything. Let's just forget about it.
Forget about what?
I tell you, that girl is really tanning my jerky.
I know. She censored my lewd dude. Somewhere in this house, there's a pile of crotches.
What the gosh doodle is this?
It's baby's breath. Isn't that a cuter than cute little planter?
I can't smoke this. I'd feel a fool. I want her out of here.
Yeah, me too.
Try to be patient. The poor dear's been through a lot.
I made you a virgin daiquiri, Mrs. Oblong. I said virgin.
Bitch, gotta go. Excuse me, do you take this stool softener internally or just apply it directly to the stool? Hallelujah, I'm home. As soon as we get home, Mommy's gonna spend some quality time with you.
Oh boy.
Hello? Oh no, that's impossible. Beth is right. Uh-oh, we'll be right down.
Pickles, did you forget Beth again?
I could have sworn she drove us home.
Mrs. Oblong, you have left your daughter at the mall, an off-track betting parlor, in a giblet bucket at the slaughterhouse, Akron, Ohio.
Your Honor, if the mother's unfit, you must acquit.
Sweetie, that doesn't make sense.
It doesn't have to. It rhymes.
Mrs. Oblong, you need to learn to be a more responsible parent. I therefore sentence you to community service as a den mother to your local little Amazon troop. Did you hear me?
Yeah, I heard you. I'm sorry, honey. It's not as if we can build a girl out of spare parts.
It's true. I've tried.
Maybe there's another way.
Well, what's the other way?
Oh, right.
We're all going to starve in this icky alley. I'm too blonde to die.
Pristine, get a hold of yourself.
I'm okay now.
I'll tell you when you're okay. All right, happy hour's over. What does that mean, girls?
Oh! The bars are getting rid of their leftover buffalo wings.
And the assorted tangy sauces.
This way!
Happy dump day!
Happy dump day, sweetheart. When I lived in the hills, I threw away my trash. Now that same trash is my bounty. Funny, isn't it? Huh? Does it worry anyone that I can't stop laughing?
Mommy can't live with that racket.
Good night, my little schmuzzle wuzzle pookie wookie.
Pickles, do you think it queer that there's smoke rising from under her covers?
Now, Bob, according to Dr. Spock, if you worry about every little thing, we could give her a complex. Oh, God. Jiminy Cricket! Bravo, baby, bravo.
Thank you, dearest.
Kids, I'm gonna ask you a question and I want you to be brutally honest. Is Mommy still sexy?
Gross. Aren't you like 30 or something?
Thanks.
I think you're beautiful, Mommy.
Oh, baby.
You have a pretty mustache.
My Bob isn't attracted to me anymore, Anita.
Let me get you a drink.
I'm too depressed to drink. Just give me a beer and a shot.
Ugh. How dare you steal my husband?
Me? I'm married to the Lord.
Hey, I'm married to the Lord.
Oh, no, you're not.
Why, you dirt?
Why, you...
Nonviolence!
Your first driver's license. My boys are growing up. Soon you'll be drafted and go off to fight and die in some godforsaken rice paddy. And for what? For what?
Dad, she's doing it again.
Pickles, dear, good news. Two more designated drivers in the house.
Mommy's back.
My goodness, that's gonna rattle like the dickens. And we have no money for a new car.
Now, Bob, we should just thank the Lord our boys weren't hurt. Anyone see my Chippendales lighter?
I think I saw it in the front seat.
Oh, why me? Why me? You'll be okay on the bus, sweetie. I wrote our number on the back of your underwear. Or someone's underwear.
The Debbies think they're so great. Why do there have to be beautiful people anyway?
So the people who aren't beautiful will know who to follow. It's all part of God's great plan.
Sexy and deep. Talk about your combo platter.
Thank you, dearest. You're quite a feast yourself.
Aw, get a room.
Yeah, a room. Where you do it.
Nice one, dude. Thanks, dude.
The Debbies run the whole school. It's just not fair.
Now. Being a whiny Wilma will get you nowhere.
I want you more right now than I've ever wanted a man.
Well, I don't like the way things are, and I'm gonna do something about it.
Son, don't rock the boat. The only way we ever achieve change is by doing absolutely nothing over a long period of time.
Bob Oblong, you are sex. I'm gonna go upstairs and start plugging things in.